Carson Wentz.
And remember, he was just a two-year starter at North Dakota State, but he won two national championships as their starting quarterback.
Pretty good resume.
Not so bad. He has great size, 6'5", nearly 240 pounds. And he was locked in a battle with Jared Goff out of Cal about who the best quarterback was in the draft. Those that favored Carson Wentz, they liked his athleticism first and foremost to run the football very well.
So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect. Offense looking to avoid a third and long at second and 10. Play fake to Matthews. Now it's Wentz. He targets Jordan Matthews and it's caught. And he's going to get this inside the 30. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. So the offense has it first and 10. They go play action here on first down. This will be caught inside the 10. That one good for 17 yards, and now they've got it first and goal. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down. So the incomplete pass brings up second down. Now Wentz again. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Their dangerous wide receiver, his second touchdown on the season. And the Eagles have taken the early lead. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
Everyone has a section in their playbook called the quick game. That was a super quick game. Out of the hands of the thrower, bam, right to the receiver.
Here's Pat O'Donnell now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away. And boy, it's another boomer. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Eagles offense now gets set to head back onto the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. Back to the air on second down. Wentz. And bringing it in, this is Salek over the middle. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is that now with his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
And give him 12 yards and a first down. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't
they?
Yeah,
when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time. Really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
Now Wentz. And his throw is going to be incomplete. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Once again here on second and 10. Throwing right, and that's complete. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw.
And complete to Zach Ertz. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25.
And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
So here we go, first and 10 now. Back live with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Eagles with the ball here to begin quarter number two. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to go up top for the end zone. And they went big on first down. Proves unfruitful.
Fans do love the long ball, don't they? And he already found his guy once. Tried to give him another chance there, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. Couldn't connect, but as you alluded to, he does have that touchdown from earlier, trying to keep him in the rhythm. Wentz will try again on second down. And this is Salek here with a grab. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the ball, as we just saw there.
Looking left side, he's got it, complete. It goes as a gain of 8 that moves the chains. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defensive side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
Now, this will be the 9th play on this drive. From the red zone now, Wentz. And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. Their dangerous wide receiver. His 2nd touchdown of the game, his 3rd on the year. And the Eagles add on to their lead. So they've had 2 drives, and he's had the 2 receiving touchdowns.
And how about a game plan where you decide to force feed or feature someone, and it works? First 2 drives, as you noted, end up in touchdowns.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. So after the INT, here's Wentz. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he gets it here to right around the 24 before he's out of bounds.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they'll set up shop in enemy territory. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. This is taken at the 3. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Here now, another look at the rookie Carson Wentz leading his offense back out there. And he's looked pretty good. Does have the 1 interception, but 2 touchdown passes so far. Your analysis?
They'll take the offset. When you're talking about throwing 2 touchdown passes, no one wants to see an interception thrown, but those things happen in the course of a ball game and over the course of a season. But throwing 2 touchdown passes, that's why the team has an advantage. That's what they're looking for more of.
He'll be hoping to make it a 3-to-1 ratio here in the 2nd quarter. 2 minutes remain here in the 1st half. We're back to Soldier Field following this short break. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Larry Ridley will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
They go play action here on first down. Deep drop, looking deep downfield. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
I guess they figure with a guy who is that hot downfield, who knows how to get the ball into the end zone, you throw it up and give him every opportunity, even though that one fell incomplete.
Yeah, he's already been in the end zone multiple times, tried to target him again deep. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And they're going to take over right there at the... take another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Here's Pat O'Donnell now as he's on to punt for Chicago. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Taken in at the 11. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And the Eagles take possession. And now the Eagles offense back out onto the field. And two interceptions already here in this first half. That's got to affect him a little bit, right? He's got to be thinking about it.
He's got to be thinking about it, but most of the good ones, they find a way to put it aside. They're not happy about it by any stretch of the imagination. They find a way to put it aside and continue to play their game.
Can he put it aside? Let's find out. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. And never good on a pass completion there to go the wrong way. Lost yardage.
No, for some reason, it seems to work better when you throw it downfield or you can move the ball downfield running it that way, doesn't it? But in this case, if you're the defensive guys, you're energized, executed well, and you caused a lost yardage play. That's going to feel good and look great in film.
Holding offense.
So oftentimes you see defensive holding. Here it's offensive holding for the flag. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Wentz to throw on second down. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they will take over at the 26-yard line. So that. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This will be fielded at the 6. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception picked off by Micah Hyde. Well, Charles, he's thrown 5 picks in a game. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. We focus our attention on the Bears defense now. We've got a tie ball game, but saw some points in half number 1, so certainly some adjustments to be made.
And I still remember playing, and one of the best halftime adjustment speeches I ever got from a coach.
Oh, boy.
You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
There's nothing to change, guys. Just play better. I mean, it was that simple. Can you play with more intensity? Can you play with more focus? Can you carry out your assignments better? If we do that, we don't need to adjust a thing. Let's see if they have that type of a strategy coming out in the second half.
What strategy will it be? Time to see. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. On second down, here's Wentz. Ertz over the middle. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. That catch good for five. It's third down. And they only need a little bit here. Third down and very short.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
And it's caught by Salah. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A big play there on the catch and run, and it'll give him a fresh set of downs.
And when an offense is doing a nice job selling the play-action pass, a lot of responsibility shifts to the linebackers. They're the ones that have to determine run or pass and get to the proper places on the field.
And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. A big play there. His third touchdown of the game and fourth on the year. And the Eagles have taken the lead.
And that third counter there gives them the lead, and it's obvious they've needed everything that he's given them today. The three touchdowns, that's impressive, but without them, they're not winning this game.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to go up top again. And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. Their dangerous wide receiver with a career-high four-touchdown game. And the Eagles had six to their lead. And let's count them up now. One, two, three, four touchdown receptions for him in this game.
And just one shy of the NFL record. What a great performance. Going up and catching the football, creating space, and finding the end zone.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by the linebacker, Jarrell Freeman. And he brings it back. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. This is taken at the three. Here comes Eagle offense now as they get set to take over here. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened.
And that's caught inside the 35. And all the way down to the 29. It's a big play there for the Eagles. 52 yards.
Remember how much we enjoyed watching him last week?
It's the same thing this week. Look at those numbers.
I'd hate to be a defender right now because no matter what they're throwing at him in terms of coverages, he's finding ways to defeat it. And even when he's covered, he's not covered. Hey, what is he doing? What's that term they use? He's uncovering.
Uncoverable.
And making big catches. Really fun to watch.
On first and 10, here's Wentz. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. Wentz will try again on second down. And Matthews over the middle with a grab. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps. It cuts towards the middle of the field, and now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
Oh, so frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
Again, it's Wentz. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And a big turnover there as... Here's Pat O'Donnell now. He's been terrific so far. Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. That'll go as a punt of 32 yards. And the Eagles will be backed up deep to get the drive started as they take over first and 10. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
It's a pickup of 19, and it'll be first down Eagles.
Love the call by the offensive coordinator, recognizing the situation very well, calling for the play-action pass, and completing it.
And the defense in desperate need of a stop. They have to get off the field and get the ball back to their offense if they want a chance. They go play-action here on first down. He's going to air one out. And that's caught inside the 35. A big play there for Philly. And even 50 yards. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. They go play action for Matthews. Now Wentz. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And he returns it here to his own 18-yard line. So there is still time, a little over 50 seconds to go, but this becomes a critical onside kick. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number as empirical.
A slot man in motion right.
Move,
And they'll send the slot in motion left. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. They'll send a receiver in motion to the left. And the play clock is going to run out here. They're in no hurry to get a play off.
Delay of game, offense.
Well, I know at points in this when you wanted to close.
Hello. Word up, I'm really good at putting words up. I make them levitate and circle with the birds. I don't need to force it, I let it occur. Whatever occurs, thank you. Feel like I was touched by an angel. Once again, a whole nother angle. I got a lot of holes in my ankle. I got a lot of love and a whole lot of ignorance. And that's a good thing if you want to relate. I'm just trying to relate. I'm just trying to relate. I'm trying to relate. I'm trying to relate.
Hello.
It's come out like a power with an M. I get down like gravity, rap, rackety, rapper to rap, rapidly follow the rabbit into the rapid to being rapping, unraveling, rattle riddles and ribbons into the sky. I'm a rebel, feeling rivety, rhythmically clear, right? Your vigorous runner right to the rhythm, riddle the side eye. I am the kid in the grasses. I am the kid in the corner with the glasses.
I am the specter, you should respect
her. I don't expect a special, ain't special. I don't expect nothing. I'm just really glad I can say something. That's a blessing. Ain't no stress affecting my presence. But sometimes the pressure keep pressing. Worst keeps my impression impressed. That's the way to relate.
I'm just trying to relate. I'm just trying to relate. I'm just trying to relate. I'm just trying to relate.
Fellas, we've got to have a great practice today. There's no other option. We've got 17 weeks. Everything all right with you? Listen to me. You're an established player in this league. That comes with expectations. And today's performance didn't live up to those expectations. So let's change that for next practice, all right?
Platinum plaques in my portfolio. My lines are finest. They blow your mind like
seclorum, e pluribus unum. They change the climates and we place in humans.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. This guy was a secondary's worst nightmare last week. He had a huge game catching the football in that win. If he's able to do even close to that same amount of damage in this one, they should be looking at another victory for sure. It's the Steelers going up against the Eagles. With that, it's time to hook up with our commentators in the booth as we turn it over to Brandon Guyton and Charles Davies.
Thank you, Larry. It's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look live there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the Philadelphia Eagles. 2-1-1 teams here, each looking to move over 500, and we're underway here in week three. And he'll be out of bounds across the 25. Come out with one back and three tight ends. Backing up. And the pressure gets to Bradford and down he goes. The former Buckeye, Cameron Hayward, in there to drop him with his first sack of 2016. Now Bradford on second down. This is intercepted, picked off by Mike Mitchell, and he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line. Certainly not